you mentioned you know real cops. Now, certainly, you probably met your fair share of real cops
doing
the Shield. Was there a point where you said, okay, did you go out on runs or do any of that, or did that all just happen naturally from...
Did I do runs, like drug runs? What are you talking about?
Oh, runs with police officers. You know, they
drug runs. Did you just start dealing heroin?
I wanted to see
research
both sides,
for the role.
Of course, man. That's how we roll in LA, man.
You do a run, you know, you jump in the passenger seat of the cop car and drive around and, bust some hookers or something.
I tried to when I was on the Shield at the beginning of that. They refused to let me do ride-alongs because we had...
Oh, ride-along. All right.
Well, I'll start out ride-alongs. Cops didn't want anything to do with it because there was a lawsuit pending against our show for trying to base it for Los Angeles, you know, because they had a whole Rampart scandal that happened back in 97, and this is like 3 or 4 years later. It just seemed to like fuel a lot of fire and thought that it would do more harm than help. Uh-huh. You know, but we kept saying it is a TV show. So anyways, they weren't cool at the beginning, but after that, I definitely have gone ride-alongs. I've gone helicopter chases after, you know, rape victims, shootings, whatever it is. So I've been out there, you know, drug bust. The whole
so
kind
how does
of
that
deal.
Work? They're just like, KJ, just kind of
I
wait
had to
in the
stay back.
Back.
Yeah. And then, you know, when they take them down and before they, So, I mean, I got to say this. When I was in Oklahoma the last time, they did 3 drug busts in one morning. And one of them, they brought one of the guys down. There was about $400,000 worth of, like, crack cocaine and regular cocaine. And it was, like, a big deal. So they had all the, you know, news there. And they were interviewing the captain to say, you know, this is our, you know, we... did this bus and we got these guys, and then all of a sudden one of the guys stops. He goes, wait a minute. He goes, you're Lem, man. You're that guy from the Shield. He goes, you're from the Shield. Oh my God. He goes, what are you down here helping these guys? And I'm like looking at him like, I said, dude, you're going away for like 20 years for this. What are you excited? You know, it was really weird because he didn't see anything there. He thought I was a cop helping Oklahoma cops.
Right.
I'm like, I'm not a cop, you know. but I've definitely, you know, experienced some of it. And I go out shooting a lot with the cops too. And, you know, and run into a lot of cops who want to throw, you know, they say, man, we feel like we should just throw you in the car and just go and you know, like you're one of us. So for whatever reason.
Do you have the temptation? Now, certainly you wouldn't want to walk away from a lucrative on-camera career, but is there that... sort of
to be a cop.
Temptation to be a cop a little bit?
Man, No.
I didn't think so. I'd give it a shot, you know? Maybe.
I'm infatuated with crime, with how they solve crimes, with what goes on in the world, with good and bad. I mean, I've got a fascination for that. You know, like the same thing with war, military. I'm extremely fascinated, but... I'm more of an observer and I admire it. And if I can bring some of what they do to what I do, then it's a cool thing. I've always wanted to be in the military when I was younger. I didn't end up doing that. Cop, no, man. I mean, those guys are brave every day.